New day, new vlog, new interesting things. I don't know. I just finished editing, you know, the previous video, the previous vlog, and now we're back on the new episode. Just made some lunch and now we're working on music. Luca already started. We're having a little quick break just so that we can eat in peace. But hey, non-stop, never ending, as you can hear. I said I'm gonna keep you posted for every single step that I do on this ginger bug, and I will. This is day two of feeding the ginger bug. It smells like ginger. It doesn't foam as much as it did before. I'm gonna stir it, I'm gonna grate ginger in and add the sugar and stir it again, and that's it. And then wait. Okay. Ah, there we go, there's the foam. Have to mix it. Oh, and now the smell comes out as well. Maybe I added a little bit too much of water because it's a bit high, as you can see, like, you know, the height of the whole thing in the jar is a bit too tall, too high. Apparently, all the ginger, while producing these cultures, these probiotics, the yeast and everything, ginger is eating that sugar. So at the end of it all, this will have less sugar than we think. Does it make sense? I don't think it makes sense, but apparently I read on the internet. Yeah, sources, just trust me, bro. Seriously though, apparently it should have less sugar than what we're putting in because it's using that sugar. I did it, I fed it. Day two, and I'm gonna go play some Genshin Impact. Ooh! I'm going to play Genshin Impact, but first I'm waiting for this video to finish rendering. Here you go, 95%. And this is my video for tomorrow, Wednesday. Uploading this today actually already, so that it's ready to just be published tomorrow. This is the first season, the first three episodes of The Walking Dead Telltale series. I'm really happy how it all turned out. So yeah, I'm excited to put it up and see what it does. And I already have some treats for myself. Salted caramel, you know, high protein so that I feel better about myself and everything else that I'm putting in my body. Salted caramel ice cream and Genshin Impact. Such a good day, isn't it? Done with the stream, then we're gonna go watch Alien Romulus. Luke, are you excited? I heard some good reviews about the movie. They say it's pretty crazy.
I'm curious what they're gonna develop now with this, with the plot.
Apparently they're reviving the first movies.
Okay, but yeah. Where is this one situated?
Well, I don't know. Okay. That's gonna be a surprise for us, for us both. Alien is, in my opinion, one of the best franchises. The original Alien, Predator, all that, and now this one also. I'm expecting huge things. I'm expecting it to be really, really great. Do you have any expectations, Luca?
No.
Luca has no expectations. And I actually, honestly, don't want Alien franchise to ever end. I will let you know how, you know, our first impressions when we get back.
Guys, it was a really good movie, right?
Yeah.
It was really good.
And let's not talk about the story, because it is what it is. But I have to say, and Luca will agree, disagree, give his opinion. Sound design,
yeah.
Picture, like...
The only thing where it bothered me, like, there is a certain event that happens right at the end of the movie, and it's seen as a CGI. You can see it.
Oh,
computer,
yeah,
generated.
Okay. A lot of things were super mechanical. You know, the alien?
Yeah, yeah.
Super mechanical. Like,
awesome. The characters, I mean, the main character is not even the main character. The main character is this robot, right? I mean,
yeah, from my opinion, yeah, it's the same. The Andy guy.
Honoring the first movies, the beginning of Alien, everything. Like, it came full circle, even the Covenant in a way, right? Yeah. Even the Covenant in a way got incorporated. Everything was really good. I was very impressed. I expected a lot, and hey, I liked the movie. You know, like, you could say that Alien movies are a recycle thing and then it's always the same thing, but I don't know, somehow they managed to make it fresh and good, new.
Yeah. And I like that some scenes were like very much revealing, sort of like gore killing and stuff.
Yeah.
But some scenes were just like blurred and that kind of.
Yeah. They just gave you the feeling what's happening, but not like everything.
Yeah.
We got some McDonald's because we got thirsty. We don't want to spoil it, so we talked about it, but I feel like it would be cool if we just gave you like a rating. For me, 4 euros something was the ticket. I think it's the easiest 4 euros I've ever spent. Like, now looking back, it's like there's so many movies that I spent maybe more and I was like disappointed. Let's call what was that, Dwayne Johnson? The Beast. Or something.
Terrible
movie.
Don't even start with that one.
So yeah, easiest 4 euros, and I will give this movie a 9 out of 10. Luca?
Yeah, same. It was a great 2 hour just immersive watching. I wasn't in any sense
bored.
Felt to be, yeah, to be bored or to be not engaged in the story. It's always something. It's great.
I think this was more of an introduction of Alien movies to the newer generation.
Yeah.
Because nothing crazy happened. It was just more like, oh yeah?
I think I read the comment on a show, a new way, like a new reboot of another franchise, Alien one.
They did add a component that I haven't seen before. We haven't seen before, really.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's gonna go in that direction, but if it does, it's gonna be another upgrade to the franchise. Okay. I don't have more to say. Can't really tell you much, you know?
Yeah.
Without spoiling.
But which upgrade?
This is our quick review of Romulus. And yeah, go check it out if you have the option.
Not sponsored.
Time to feed our bug again, our ginger bug. It's day 4, I think. I'm so crazy that instead of one, I just made another one. The more, the merrier. Gonna have so much ginger beer. It's gonna be awesome. So basically have everything prepared. Like all the things that I need every morning, I have this ready. So I just take it and I start feeding it. First, our 4 day ginger bug.
3.
It looks pretty normal. Let's give it a mix. No balloons anymore. This big one is still foaming quite a bit, actually. That's good. And I can definitely smell this one as well. Hey, maybe it stopped. I mean, stopped. Maybe it slowed down the whole process. I just hope it didn't die. That would suck. I might actually just do the same thing with this one as I did with that one. Cut some holes in a paper. So that it has a bit more air coming in. Hopefully, you know, that does it a little bit better. Day 4, day 1. There you go. We are actually taking that day 5 bug, like this one, the smaller one, out tomorrow. And I think we're starting to make the ginger beer. Since I was at the movies, I am now rewatching Alien vs. Predator movies. I'm probably gonna watch all of them. I'm going through them in a chronological order instead of how the movies came out. I'm now on Alien versus Predator. I have to tell you, it's pretty interesting to rewatch these movies again and again and catch the different details. Because, you know, when these movies were coming out, I was really, really young. I mean, some of them were even out before I was born. So, gonna watch that chill for a bit before the stream. I already did all the content. Maybe I will edit something. I don't know yet. But I'm gonna take it a little bit more chill today. Just to refresh, reset and all that.
This is like waking in the middle of the night because you have a kid. You know, a little baby to take care of. My baby. Triplets.
Now since I'm up, you know, and ready for work, I have like 30 minutes before we leave. I'm gonna make some clips from the streams. Gonna make some TikToks and stuff, you know. I'm exhausted, but hey, it is what it is, right? I don't want to work today. Luca, do you want to work today? We don't want to work today. I want to sleep for like 2 more hours and edit videos and edit TikToks and work on music.
You know what I want?
What?
I want to sleep and then, as you said, like in 2 hours, I would take my blanket to the living room and like cover myself with that and then watch a movie.
Mm-hmm.
And then maybe fall asleep, back asleep. And then maybe wake up again and eat something. You know, that would be like until 11 a.m. And then I might start the day.
Now we just hope the work is gonna be good. Do you have any predictions?
About work?
Yeah. Work was okay. Now we are at a venue, concert venue, and we're gonna be selling merch. I got an offer by our co-worker from Sushi if we wanna help selling merch. So yeah, some, you know, extra cash. But it's also gonna be free concert, so great. Whole area back there that I just showed you is backstage, and basically there are, you know, artists hanging around, drinking, eating, preparing for the concert. And that right there is where we're gonna work. Just gonna be in there selling. I mean, I'm probably not gonna even be selling. I'm just gonna sort stuff out, like sizes of t-shirts or whatever they have, making sure everything goes okay. I don't even know. Tickets sold 20,000. Everything, apparently. So, you know, rumors, let's call it like that. Allegedly, everything is done last minute. So a lot of things are not even sorted yet. I think the most important thing is probably sorted, which would be the sound. And everything else is kind of like, they don't know. I would organize a concert here if I would, I mean, I would play if I would be able to sell it.
You know, the thing that bothers me is that there is no more screens here.
Somewhere. For example, if there would be one screen, like one big screen,
yeah,
to cover the VIP area, the dead VIP area, whatever that is.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe have it like there.
Oh yeah, it's live broadcasted, so they could have more screens and all that.
Yeah.
And well, let's see what we have to do here with the merchandise. Saturday, done with work. It was an early one, even earlier than yesterday. Now we are on our way to the concert venue. I will show you as much as I will be able to. For the most part, I will try to show you the concert itself and stuff like that. I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty tired. Luca, are you tired? I'm pretty tired. It's been a long day already, and it's gonna
yesterday
be.
It was a long day, and today it's just like continuing. So
yesterday no was the longest. Yeah, yesterday was a really long day. Today was a long day, and it just keeps going. We'll rest tomorrow on a Sunday.
Ja, tako je, odlično.
Hvala lepa.
A ti je znam?
A ja, šarlatan, ja, valjda imamo.
We're done. It's almost 2 a.m. It was tiring. I'm dead. I'm done. Our primary job, or what we were called for, was basically that when the cashier or the front desk gets an order, let's say they want this t-shirt, black t-shirt, size large, then we go get it, basically. That was our description, as like we were told what we will do. And then it turned out into, let's say, promotion, talking to people. It was good. We started at 4, we finished at 2. Now we're gonna drop dead, tired. I don't know. Whenever we wake up tomorrow, we wake up. I guess that's all there is.
Good morning. This is day 6, and let's check our black. I like that it's very, very clean. There's bubbles on the side, as you can see. Okay. Wow, that's a lot of bubbles and everything. Let's see this one.
Okay.
This one's actually bad. There's mold. I'm throwing that one away because I don't think I can fix mold. The other two are great. So yeah, I'm gonna feed them, and then we are making ginger beer. Thank you. These are the ginger beers. Hopefully they will be okay. I had some issues, I had some problems with practically everything, every aspect of this making and filming and everything. At some point when I was pouring things in, my camera battery died, so I didn't get the footage of me actually pouring stuff in. But the last thing that I remembered you saw was me putting in the ginger bug, the ginger starter, in the bottle, and then I just topped it off to the levels that you can see with that ginger beer, or like with that ginger mix where we blended everything in a blender. So I just topped it off to like this height. I would prefer it if it would be like up to here, right, as it is in this one, but I didn't have enough while the mixture. So it is what it is. One really important thing is that you have to mix these quite well, because there was sugar that we added. So you want to make sure that sugar gets dissolved, or rather that goes, that distributes itself nicely throughout the whole liquid, so that the ginger yeast has food. I opted in for the plastic bottles because they allow for, you know, the yeast and everything to expand. It's not gonna burst. So what's next? I have to leave this out here for at least one day. Tomorrow, we should have a bottle that is quite firm to the touch. It should be tomorrow. If it's not, then we have a problem. And then we have to let the air out. And then we have to repeat that for another 2 days, and then we can put it in the refrigerator. But that's it. That's the ginger beer. Hopefully it works. If not, I still have another one. I still have another batch. Have another one here. This is basically the old one, but like topped with water and fed with sugar again. And then we have more ginger if I wanna try, you know, the whole thing again. This was the ginger beer. I hope it's gonna be good. You will see the whole process, like the continuation of this whole ginger beer making, in the next vlog. But this was just the start. Second week of making ginger beer. I wanted to go through some do and don'ts. Maybe more like a helping tip if you will make this ginger beer at home, if you will try to make it at home. I found that out later, but first tip that I would probably give you, helpful tip, is to not use regular spoon. Go for a plastic one, maybe wooden, just don't use the metal ones. Apparently it messes up with the something with the yeast, some acidity, something. It don't use that, go for plastic or go for something else. Second, I noticed a far better result if I added less sugar and less ginger when I was feeding it. At first I fed it one full tablespoon of ginger, one full tablespoon of sugar. I think that's a bit too much. I would go for maybe 1 teaspoon, maybe 2 teaspoons. I started adding 1 teaspoon of ginger, 1 teaspoon of sugar, and it worked just as well. I think it gives a little bit of space, a little bit of room for the whole yeast to breathe, to not overeat, and then you get better results. Well, hopefully, but that's how I noticed that it kind of progressed a little bit better. I also read that you can add lemon juice and that you can add lemon peel to it after your liquid is at room temperature. Another thing, as you noticed, I used erythritol, if that's how you pronounce it. Basically a sweetener and not sugar. Why, you ask? Sugar or honey would feed the yeast, and then you would basically just reactivate the whole process of fermentation and whatever, because you use sugar to activate it, right? You use these sweeteners to make it actually sweet without activating the yeast. Does that make sense? Makes sense. This is my first time working with this, especially like drinks, so I made one drink with it, a little bit more, like let's say that I added 2 tablespoons, I think it was, and then another one with 1 tablespoon. I think that's more than enough. I don't know, like we will see, we'll have to taste test it, but yeah, it should work, it should be fine, hopefully. Oh yeah, you remember that one batch that gone bad, that got mold? Don't try stuff. We made a terrible mistake of taste testing the actual starters, and I feel like we cross-contaminated some of the, you know, like one jar was apparently contaminated. I didn't clean it well enough, or when we were testing, we did something to it that it messed it up. So yeah, when you're testing, maybe, like, I guess my helpful tip, again, as if I'm some kind of, you know, knowledge holder, just try it once and then throw that spoon away or whatever you're using and take another one. Unfortunately, I mean, more to clean, but at least you will ensure that the result is optimal, at least. Anything else that I want to share with you? Not really. I mean, overall, it's been super simple. There were a couple of things that I learned and I wanted to tell you as well. So maybe you will not do those same mistakes that I did. If you have a suggestion for me, feel free to tell me. So I will use those suggestions for next time that I'm making the ginger beer. It's been a week. It's been eventful. It's been everything. And this next one is going to be even more eventful. We have a lot of things coming up. I know that this vlog is already past 20 minutes. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I will see you on the next one, and bye-bye.